Amen. 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 God is doing something different. Amen. I'm not going to say something new because there ain't nothing new up under the sun. Amen. Amen. But he is doing something different, and I appreciate God on today. So as I was looking through some scriptures on today, amen, God's been dealing with me, and he was talking to me about it's time for a celebration. Amen. And when you look up the definition of celebration, to honor publicly, to make an occasion with happy festivities. Amen. And I was sitting here just trying to think of some things, and he said the title should be, it's a time for celebration. Amen. Amen. And what are we celebrating? The subtitle is Old Things Have Passed. Out with the old and in with the new.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. So as I was sitting here just kind of listening to the Lord, amen, he told me something about Hezekiah Walker, and I couldn't think of the song, but clearly I just asked Kathy to play the song, amen, and she figured out the one that needed to be played. And as I was listening to the psalmist, she said somehow the Lord is going to make a way somehow. Amen. Then Apostle got up this morning during praise and worship, and he was talking about what you're not going to see tomorrow. Amen. Amen. Out with the old on today.
Uh-huh.
In with the new on today. So
yes.
That is where my text is coming out. Amen. And I don't know where it's going to be ending, but know that the focus verse, amen, is going to be verse 13. Amen. And now Pharaoh drew nigh the children of Israel. Amen. Lifted up their eyes, and behold, the Egyptians marched after them, and they were sore afraid. And the children of Israel cried out unto the Lord. Surely the woman of God has spoken a word that was in season. Surely he has been listening to our cries. He has been listening to our pleas. He has been listening to our petitions. He's moving swiftly to move on the request that we have made unto him. Amen. The secret to that is you got to be obedient. Amen. Amen. Faith without works is dead. So you got to step out some stuff today in order to obtain the promises that were spoken for you. I know a word might have been spoken over some of us, but what are you doing to bring it to pass? Are you putting it in the master's hand, or are you taking it back and working it out for yourself? Because the word of God says he can work all things out for the good of those who love the Lord. That's telling me he don't need nobody's help up in here. He's saying all you need to do is praise me. All you need to do is pray to me. All you need to do is fast. All you need to do is seek me.
Joy is right here, and right now.
the Egyptians, for it had been better for us to serve the Egyptians than that we should die in the wilderness. I started listening to Evan Davis up in my message yesterday, talking about how the children of Israel are talking about how good they had it up in Egypt. Who's been a slave to sit up in here and thought it was some kind of good? You can't eat the way you want to eat. You can't talk the way you want to talk. You can't dress the way you want to dress. You can't get yourself educated. You can't do nothing but some music, or I guess my psalmist is going to give me some music. Because I'm just going to go talk to a couple of people.
Yes. Yes, God.
Amen.
Amen.
God is faithful.
Amen.
And he is just.
Yes.
And he's going to do what he said.
Yes.
He was going to do.
Yes, God.
Amen.
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 Amen. By your spirit.
Amen.
Hallelujah!